So, back in July of 2010, there was a final patch released for Aliens vs. Predator on Steam, which was supposed to stabilize the balance issues on the multiplayer. So, coming from someone who's played this game for 5 years on Xbox 360, I finally got a chance to try out this balance patch, and I'm going to give you guys my thoughts on all the changes. So, this is the balance patch that console players never got to experience. So, they increase the maximum range the alien can do a focus attack. You will also get the knockdown effect much more often on this balance patch compared to the console version. They also increase the damage that the focus attack does. On the console version, it does 1 bar of damage, but on the PC balance patch, it does 2 bars of damage. Now, the patch notes say that the alien and the predator's focus attack has the same distance to lock on from maximum range. But I still feel that the alien has a little bit more range. So, with increased range, increased damage, and a knockdown effect, the alien focus attack is a lot more useful now compared to how it is on the console version. So, that's a really good upgrade for the alien. So, the next change they made was towards the heavy attack. You can no longer use a heavy attack before or during a jumping animation. So this is an issue on console because when you have enemies that are jumping around doing heavy attacks, it just made it harder to counter them with a light attack when they keep jumping all over the place. So the alien using heavy attack from a wall or ceiling has been nerfed. It only causes a flinch now, and it no longer stuns the person in place. So this will force alien players to be a little bit more mobile when using the wall or ceiling to their advantage. So you can no longer stay in one place and tail someone to death from the wall. They also adjusted the flinch time on the alien and the predator when they're attacked, so this means they recover around the same amount of time as each other. The other thing is they change it to where the predator can now be knocked down after being countered. And that is a really good change. Yes, it does make the predator more vulnerable, but at the same time, it balances out the melee combat between the alien and the predator. So on the console version, that would almost never happen. They would only flinch from being hit by a grenade blast or from being countered on their light attack. They also adjusted the range and the angle where you can perform a stealth attack on someone else. So this means you now need to be a little bit closer and on the correct angle to do it. Now, the flamethrower has a small buff. It will now ignite the enemy you are hitting as long as you take away 25% of the health with the flamethrower, and it will burn until they die. Although this may sound like a good buff for the flamethrower, I still don't think it's good enough to replace the pulse rifle. And that's just because you have to find the weapon, and when you have it's got limited range. They also made a change to where if a marine would block an enemy's light attack, they would still take 50% of that damage instead of getting hit by 100% damage when not blocking. It's really strange, but I guess their intention was force marine player to block more often instead of just taking a flinch and shooting the player. Now, I was also curious about the dedicated server list. So, as you see, there are some really good ping servers that are close to me. However, they're empty. Which is really strange because when you have so many servers on the East Coast or West Coast of America or Canada and they have such a good ping, you would think they'd have more players. But it's strange to see the majority of the players during this review were mostly going to UK servers. But the other strange thing is when I play in these UK servers, it's pretty stable to some extent. But when I look at the ping list, it seems like a lot of people have a really high ping to the UK server. So it just means they're not based in the UK. Maybe they're playing from America or Canada or maybe from Japan, Australia, or Russia, you know, somewhere really far. So I'm just wondering why they choose to go to a UK server when, of course, they could find another server that has a shorter ping to their connection. Now, on the positive side, there's a really good feature which is called Join Session in Progress. This is something a lot of games tend to have, but some games out there tend to miss. So, joining a session in progress just means you can join a game that is already active. So, that's really good on PC for Aliens vs. Predator because you don't want to sit in a lobby and wait for players to join. You want to find an active lobby, join, and start playing, and that is great. So, this is me trying to find a ranked match on the PC version. And this is pretty much the same thing you will see on the Xbox 360 version. So yeah, no one really plays ranked matches on PC or on Xbox 360. As for the PlayStation 3 version, I'm not too sure because I never played on that one. So this means that ever since that balance patch was released on the PC, they adjusted it to where players will gain XP in player matches. So that means you can unlock all your skins and level up just by playing in one of the many dedicated servers that are available. And of course, you're going to find one or two, or maybe just a few of them, that do have some players in there. Now, the last thing I want to point out is something regarding the number of players in these servers. Now, I noticed some of these servers, if not all of them, tend to have a maximum cap of up to 18 players. And I think that's an absurd amount of players to have in a map like Refinery or even Jungle or Gateway. Like, I've played this game for 5 years on Xbox 360, and I've hosted a lot of games for players, and I've been very familiar with how many spawning places are available on the maps and how big the maps are. And I think for a map like Refinery, it's good having 9 players, but having 18 is just ridiculous. I mean, if you like having a clusterfuck of a ton of people shooting you when you spawn and not being able to move like 30 feet without getting shot by shoulder cannons or getting jumped on by aliens raping your face or something, that's great. You might like that stuff, but in an essence of keeping the flow of gameplay smooth and populated, I still think most of these maps are good for about 9 players. I usually host it for 3 of each species, so 3 predators, 3 aliens, 3 marines, just to keep it fair and balanced. But having 18 is a shitload of stuff to deal with. I'm not saying you have to be a great player, I'm just saying there's a lot of people to kill, and sometimes the frame rate will suffer because of that, and it does get a little bit laggy, even on a dedicated server. So, coming from a fan who's played this game on Xbox 360 for 5 years and is very familiar with the flow of balance on the console version, I gotta say, after playing the balanced version on PC, it is definitely a lot better. It is more balanced now between the aliens and the predators, specifically around the melee combat system, so it is a lot better. So on the downside, it does suck that console players will never get to play this version, but if you do have a chance to pick up the PC version, pick it up and try it out. So thanks for watching, please leave a thumbs up, and I'll see you later.